What are views in SQL Server? Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, I'm going to guide you over what exactly is views in SQL Server, what is the syntax of views in SQL Server with few of the examples, and along with that, I'm going to even show you how to drop a view in SQL Server. So before directly jumping into the topic views, let me give you a basic definition or a basic understanding of what exactly is a view. Okay, let us not think too technically when I'm talking about a view. In a very simple terminology, let us understand the word called view, V-I-E-W, view. What is a view? View is nothing but what we see, what we see. We are viewing it. So for example, you are viewing me, you are viewing my video, right? So I am viewing you, right? So I am viewing every day some many things from the day, from the time I wake up from my bed till I go to the bed at night. So view is nothing but it is something that you see, just you see, right? So nowhere you are going to keep it inside with you or store with you. Okay, you are just seeing it, you're just viewing it. So in the same way, the word view in SQL Server also have the same application with the basic example that I have given it to you, right? So view is nothing but it is also same like a table. It is also similar to the table, but it is a virtual table. View is what? It is a virtual table. For example, you are creating a table with the syntax create table, table name, then you give the column names, then data types, then constraints, and you create a table. So you can see the table that you have created in your database, am I right? But the view that you have created, though that is a virtual table, you cannot see it in a database. It is just a virtual table for time instance that you have created. It is not stored anywhere. Okay, so in a table also we have the records, we have the values in the form of rows and columns. In view also we have the records in the form of rows and columns, similar to the real table. Okay, so the interesting fact here in the view is that you can get the columns from table 1, table 2, table 3 and make it into one view. When I'm creating a table, I can create only one table with n number of columns in it. But you can create a view by getting the columns from many tables. Alright, so that is a very interesting fact. So most probably, let me give you the in a real time where this view will be used. Okay, so if I talk about, if you are a data analyst or if you are working on a data analyzation part, so most of the time what will happen, you will not have the right information in order to meet the client's requirement. So for example, you don't have tables in you don't have required columns or required information in table 1, but it is there in table 2, but you need to work on table 1 also to meet the client's requirement. So for that, what you will do here in SQL Server, we will create a view, and this view that we have created in a SQL Server, what we will do, we will upload it in a Power BI, we will use data modeling part and we start working on it. Okay, so that's a very interesting thing that can be done when I'm talking about a view. So let me quickly take you over what exactly is a view and what is the syntax of it on the screen, please. So here, a view in an SQL, it is a virtual table. It also contains the same like a real table. We have rows and columns. Okay, we can get the table from one or more real tables in the database. So that's where view stands for. The syntax of the view, it is very, very, very similar to the way how we create a table. Okay, so let me quickly recap you how can we create a table. Create table, table name. In the same way, create view, view name. When you are creating a table, what you will do, after you write a table name, you open the parenthesis and you start writing the column names. But here we will use the word as and we write a select statement with a condition. It's very simple. A regular select statement. I can call it to you as a regular select statement with a condition. just add create view, view name as, so that it will become a complete view. Very simple. All right. So let me give you a basic example. First basic example of a view. Then I will show you how can we create a view using the joins concept. All right. So for this, what I am doing, if you carefully see here, I have a table called order master. I have a table called order master. In this, I have multiple orders. Okay. I have grand total. I have offer ID. So on which date this order got done, and what is the, who is the delivery person, what is his email ID or what is her email ID, on which date it got delivered. We have all these informations in this order master. But what I'm going to see it here, I would like to see order ID number 5. Okay, we have multiple orders here, right? I would like to see this order ID number 5. I have to see this detail. Okay, so for this, what I'm doing, I am creating a view, okay, with a view name. I'm creating a view with a view name. So either you can create a view name of your choice. It's up to you completely, as how I have done here. If you do not like this one, view VW, we actually create a view to identify as VW underscore KnowHow. Okay, I am creating a view with a view name as, now under this select statement, I don't want to see all the columns. I would like to see only these three columns. If you would like to see all the columns, remove all these things and just write star. You'll get all the columns from it. Okay, star from which table? From order master table. So what is the condition? I would like to see order ID number 5. Okay, so I can, I'm, the command's computed successfully. Let me show you how to execute it. So now we have to execute the view name. We should not execute the table name here. We have to execute the view name here. So what I'm doing here, I am writing select star where I can fetch the records. So I am fetching my view name. So if I execute it, you can see that I have got a information what I want in the form of a table, right? All the columns and the row, which is order ID number 5. Now this is not stored anywhere. This is a virtual table. Okay, now you do some other SQL query, you execute it, this is gone. All right, but always remember, whenever we would like to see only order ID number 5 from my order master table, I can just use this view name and I can get the information. That is the biggest advantage. So now what I want, I can just use this VW underscore KnowHow, and whenever I would, I want to just see it, I, whenever I want to just view it, I can use this view name and I can fetch the record. Okay, it is like a virtual table. Whenever you want, you can just fetch it out, but it is not stored anywhere. Okay, so this is one type of example, a very simple example that I can call it as a view. But now let me show you how can we create a view using a joins concept. Okay, using a joins concept, very simple here, it's very easy, do not worry about it. Okay, now I am creating a view with a view name example join as, now there are two tables here. So for example, if I would show it to you, the customer table and the customer card table, there are two tables here. So from my customer table, I am choosing my customer first name column, I am choosing the gender column, and I am choosing the date of birth column. And from the customer cart table, I am choosing the cart ID column, I am choosing the price column. Okay, so these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to fetch these 5 columns in my output. So from which table? From customer table, table 1. I am joining it with which table? Table 2, which is customer cart, which is my customer cart table. So now I am using customer table, I am joining it with the customer cart table. On what condition? The joins condition is that two columns should have at least one common column. So what is the common column we have? Here also we have customer email, and here also we have customer email. In customer table also we have customer email, customer cart table also we have customer email. So that's where I am writing it as a common condition. Now I am writing the where clause here, and I am writing the condition that I don't want to see all the rows, I don't want to see all the records from my customer and customer cart table. I want to see only those records whose price is greater than 10, whose price is greater than 10, and the price column, we have it in a customer card table. So if I execute it, commands completed successfully. So now let me fetch the record. If I fetch the record, we see that I have got all these columns, whichever I want in the output. Customer first name, I have got gender column, I have got date of birth column, I have got cart ID column, I have got price column. And if you carefully observe, price which is greater than 10, we don't have any price which is less than 10. So 12, 13, 15, 11.50. So 11.50, 14, 38, so 39, we have all the records which are greater than 10. So that is a condition. Now what's the point is here? You can ask me a question, sir, this can be done without writing a view also. Yes, this can be done without writing a view also. But the point is that whenever you would like to fetch the records of whose price is greater than 10, now no need to write this complete join concept, just execute with the view name example join, you will get the records. Alright, so that's where it plays a very important role. So that's where view plays a very important role. Now let us see how can we drop this view that we have created. The syntax of dropping a table is drop table table name. In the same way, the syntax of dropping a view is drop view view name. Okay, so the syntax of dropping a view is drop view view name. I'm dropping a view with the name what? With the name example join. So drop view example join. So when I execute it, the commands completed successfully. I do not have any views which are there in my database now. So this is how you can create a view, the syntax of view, two different examples on view, how to drop a view in SQL Server. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.